Hellboy 2. Have you started anything on it yet?
Guillermo has been in pre-production for probably 5 or 6 months already.
You? Have you done anything yet?
I've done some fittings, you know. Some new people on the movie, so new approach to the makeup, new approach to the costumes, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So I've been involved peripherally, but very peripherally. I'm mostly playing golf in preparation.
That's a good way to prepare for it.
I think that's a good way to prepare for just about anything, but that's me.
Where's the story going to go this time?
It's going to go to Budapest, because that's where we're filming. It's bigger, it's more epic, but there's more of a time spent with the freaks, you know, the Hellboys and the Lizzes and the Ape Sapiens and a couple other new members of the BPRD. And really all the things that were endearing about the first one are, you know, looked at again and explored again. And but there's an epic sweep to it that I really can't get into.
Epic sweep.
I really want you to, you know, spend $11, or maybe 15, because by the time it comes out, it probably maybe 25. Who knows?
What do you think about Guillermo's success this past year with Pan's Labyrinth?
Oh my God! Oh my God! I mean, you know, I don't want to sound like, you know, immodest, but 15 years ago, when I saw the very first frame of this little film called Kronos that I went down to Mexico to do, which is his first film, I said, wow, this guy is like Rembrandt. I mean, you know, he has an eye that was, you know, made for cinema, and he's going to leave behind an amazing legacy. And I knew that on the first day, and now the world knows it. And it's really cool to watch. It's also great to see what a sure-handed masterpiece he made in Pan's Labyrinth. I mean, from beginning to end, top to bottom, 100%, 110% complete. And then how the world is embracing him.